good evening, and welcome to our time of prayer. We're so glad that you have chosen to join with us tonight. And tonight is especially important. We are actually recording this on Tuesday, which is Election Day in the United States. And this is one of the most contested elections that there's ever been. And there's also the possibility for the greatest civil upheaval in our neighbor to the south. There's been violence, there's been demonstrations, there's been civil unrest, and as yet, people are still, as we are recording this, going to the polls, so we don't have any returns to share. But one thing we do know is that our nation and the nation to the south need prayer. They need the hand of God. See, God is not as much concerned with the political system who is in charge as he is with the individual hearts of each person. And while we know from Romans chapter 13 that the governments are in place because of God's edict, because of what he says, and it says, let every soul be subject for the higher powers, because there is no power but of God, and the powers that be are ordained of God. So with that in mind, we want to focus our prayers on our country and mention the United States as well, with not forgetting each and every one of you as well, as part of the body of Christ and the needs that are there. Now, over the last few weeks, we've been looking at the armor of God. And last week, we looked at the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. And many people think that's the end of the armor, but as we continue on in Scripture, I think there's one more weapon that's there that we often do not take advantage of. And here's what we read. It says, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayer and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for the Lord's people. It says, pray also for me. And so one of the greatest weapons we have as the body of Christ is prayer. In Romans chapter 8, it talks about praying in the Spirit. It talks about the Spirit himself making groanings that we don't know how to put into words. See, the Holy Spirit, he looks at our hearts and he knows what the heart is. And sometimes we just don't know how to say it. But when the Spirit makes intercession for us, it's always perfect. It always is what the Father's will would be. See, that's important. When we pray, we need to pray according to the will of God. And what is his will? Well, it's contained right here in this book. And the Holy Spirit makes that discernment for us. See, we would like to think we're always objective in our prayers, but to be honest, we're not. Our prayers are quite often self-centered. Instead of your kingdom come, your will be done, in our prayers we often come across as saying, our kingdom come, our will be done. And we expect God to do what we are asking. But rather, we should be doing what he is asking, what he is requesting. So tonight as we pray, we're going to ask you to pray along with us and pray in the Spirit. Let the Spirit of God direct your hearts as you pray, not just tonight, but each and every time, that we might be instruments in the hands of our loving Heavenly Father, who so desires to have fellowship and relationship with each and every person, every one of his children. So pray with us as we begin with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And Father, we have been instructed to pray for those who are in authority over us, as Paul said to Timothy. And the reason is so that we might lead a quiet and peaceable life. And Lord, our world around us is in turmoil. It's in turmoil because of the political processes that are going on. It's in turmoil because of the COVID-19 virus pandemic. It's in turmoil because there's so much uncertainty and so much unrest in the world that we see today. We see economic stress. We see political stress. We see financial stress. We see social stress. We see mental and emotional stress. And Lord, You are the Prince of Peace. So we come to You tonight and ask that You, by Your Spirit, would do another miracle in our midst. Lord, I pray for the political process that's going on right now in the United States as it continues on, as the write-in ballots are being counted and tabulated over these next few days. And Lord, whatever the result, we leave that in Your hands. But we pray for the people. We pray that You would protect so many businesses and so many families, that they would not be subject to this rioting and vandalism that has taken place over the last few years. Even on the news yesterday, we saw so many businesses boarding up their shops that their premises might not be vandalized. Lord, that is not Your will. Your will is that people would find peace through the Prince of Peace. And so, Lord, whoever comes out on top, I pray that You would work through their hearts. I pray that the heart of the king would be in the hand of the Lord, and that You would be able to use them for righteousness, whatever their political stripe. And here in Canada, Lord, I pray for our political system. We pray for our leaders. We pray for our federal leaders, Prime Minister Trudeau. Lord, that he would listen to the voice of God, and he would do that which is righteous in Your sight. We pray for Premier Ford, Lord, that he also would listen to the voice of God. Lord, if there was ever a time we needed leaders who knew how to listen to God, it's now. We pray for our mayor, Walter Senzik, Lord, that You would minister Your grace to him as they enact legislation for the well-being of all of those that live in St. Catharines. And Lord, for Mayor Diodati, as we who live in Niagara Falls are also subject to their leadership. And so, Lord, we pray for them. And we pray that they would do that which is right in the sight of God. And Father, we also pray for the leadership within our church. God, I pray that Your Spirit would so move within each of the leaders within our church. Lord, that they would have an amazing encounter with the Spirit of God on a daily basis. Lord, from our pastor and the board of elders and the staff, Lord, we need to pray in the Holy Spirit. We need to allow the Holy Spirit to permeate everything we do, whether it be our online presence in the services that we provide, or whether it be the service on Sunday morning or the other activities of the church. God, we need that sense of the anointing of the Spirit of God in everything that we would do, from the music to the reading to the prayers to the children's ministry to the preaching of the word. God, we need so much Your anointed touch. So, Father, we come to You this night and pray on behalf of all of these things, that Your will would be done. In Jesus' name, amen. Honey, why don't you pray, as you do so well, for our children and our women's ministries, that God would just use them in a powerful way. We just need so much in Scott Street. A move of the Spirit of God within each and every heart.
Dear Father in heaven, I just lift up to You our children, Father, so they are so precious in Your sight, Father. Lord, You welcome the children so freely to You as well. And Lord, may we instill teachings of You that It is the seed being planted right now, Father. For you know where seeds in good ground, Lord, they sustain good growth. And we are providing these seeds to our children by our youth ministries, Lord. We think of Phil, Lord, as he programs with the bubble groups, getting the kids together and learning with you but still having fun. We think of Kyle with the older youth, Father, and just continuing their education in you, Father, and just showing representative of Christ in them, Lord. We pray a spirit over them, Father, of protection, Lord, because COVID is around, Lord, be it in the schools, be it, you know, outside. We just pray a hand of protection over not only our children, but well, the ladies, Father, as we get together online on a Zoom Bible study, Father, just bring our ladies to you in studying your word, Lord. Whether it be just in their home by their, you know, for reading spot, that they may open the word and that you can speak to them, Father. Lord, we think of the elderly, Lord, where they're, you know, in homes and visits cannot be as frequent, or even some, not at all, Lord. Lord, we just ask that you communicate with them, Father, as a peace that only you can give to them. We pray for the working moms, Lord, that are going out in the working force and taking care of their children and their families, Father, and still doing the everyday stuff. Give them the strength they need, for Lord, even time change is a tiring factor as kids still get up earlier, Lord. Just give them the strength that they need to follow with their duties, Lord. We pray for the younger moms, Lord, or the younger married couples, Lord, that you would just strengthen their marriages and, Father, just be a hand of protection over them that the evil one may not instill something into there, Lord. Lord, marriage is such a fragile, I don't want to say institution, but just, Lord, it just seems to be so much under attack nowadays, Father. Just make us stronger with our spouses. The love grow deeper for you, Father, and that provokes a deepness for our spouse, Lord. Just lift our hearts up to you, Lord. Father, I just also want to pray for the sick in our congregation, Father. Lord, I think of Helga Weens, Lord. Just give her that extra measure of physical healing, Lord, and a touch from you. Lord, I think of Quinn, Father, in his cancer journey, Lord. Father, it's a journey that at times he has to do on his own. We ask that he is not alone, Lord, for you are with him, Father, and give them healing there, Lord. Lord, I think of Lainey Friesen, Father, in the hospital, Lord. Just provide the doctors the knowledge and what to do there. And I just want you to insert a name while I just be silent for a moment of who comes to your mind for there are so many others that I don't even know.
Yes, Lord. So many people with so many needs, but you are so great. And as Joan has prayed for the marriages, Lord, I pray that there would be a purity in each heart. Lord, that you would guard their hearts from looking or being distracted elsewhere. Lord, it's who can ascend to the hill of God is those who have a pure heart, clean hands. So, Lord, I pray for marriages, that there would be purity there. There would not be any hidden closets or compromises, Lord, that would tend to get in like the little foxes that nip at the vines, but that marriages would be built on total trust and total commitment. Lord, that our relationship with you would be total trust and total commitment. Father, I pray for our men. Lord, some of us are meeting together on a Bible study each week. And it's rich as we share the scripture together. But Lord, there's so many others in our church and in our city that need that fellowship, need that connection. And Lord, I pray for them. Lord, the enemy would want to sift them as wheat, as Jesus said to Peter. But Lord, you said you prayed for Peter. And Lord, today we pray for these men as well. Lord, keep their eyes single. They would not be wandering, not be looking for something on the side. And Lord, we've not prayed this before, but we feel it specifically that we need to do this in this time. We pray for our marriages. As Joan has said, keep them strong. Lord, keep their love to be growing and deepening each day for each other and for you. And so, Father, we thank you so much. We thank you for the way that you provided, the way that you are doing your work. Lord, over the summer months, we prayed for the migrant workers, and now most of them have returned home. And with the coming of cold weather, the rest of them are anxious to go back home where it's warmer. But Lord, we thank you for the contributions that they have made, and pray that you would continue to keep them safe and bless them, Lord. And as we're already looking for next season, we pray that your will would be done. So, Father, there's so many things as we pray, and as the scripture says, pray in the Spirit. We ask that your will would be done and accomplished. So, Lord, we give all of these things and submit them to you. We lay them at your feet, and we thank you that your Holy Spirit is able to take those things that we don't even know how to say and present them to our Father in heaven. So with thanksgiving in our hearts, we say, so be it. Amen and amen. Well, thank you, folks, for joining us tonight. It is so important that we pray. As 2 Chronicles says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. Thank you so much for being with us tonight. May God bless you.